Hello everyone, my name is Bradley. I have a Brad Taste in Music, and today I'm going to be reacting to the 1990 album, The Laws, self-titled. Now, you might be asking, Bradley, what the fuck is this? I'm asking the same exact question, okay? I don't know what I'm listening to. I don't know what I'm getting into, but it was a paid request. And you know what? I'm always open to listening to new music, and people are also complaining. Just Returns, by the way, he's the only one complaining, that I'm not listening to any music past the 2010s, alright? So, it's a bit of a cultural reset. So, I'm pretty excited to check this out. Dynamic Editor says, a seminal record of nostalgia just before Britpop hit big. The LA's features excellent instrumentation and production from a band that seems like they were ripped out of a garage rock 60. Fuck. The LA's features excellent instrumentation and production from a band that seems like they were ripped out of the garage rock 60s with some of the most beautiful lyrics put to tape. Sounds like it's going to be a euphoric listen. Let's give it a shot. Let's do this. All right. I don't know what else to say, except for the fact that there is a song here that is clearly the breadwinner, which is There She Goes. I'm wondering if it will be something I recognize, because I have no idea if I've heard this band before, so this should be a fun journey. First track, Son of a Gun. Groove of this song is amazing. The singing's really locking me into the psychedelic vibe of this shit. Yeah, I'm falling into it. I'm enjoying it. Excellent start here. I like how it ends just kind of feeling like it's abruptly ending, giving you pretty much exactly what it needs to give you and then just kind of stopping. I love the sound of this first track. I felt like the lyrics were really interesting. I like the animal mentions here, especially the better run, rabbit, run. Run into the sun, kick your heels in the killing fields. Run, rabbit, run. When it's said, it feels very impactful, especially with this incredible singing. So far, the vibe here is impactful, I'll say, I guess. Smiley Ball really getting me hooked into the sound nicely. This is a very, very strong start. Next song, I Can't Sleep. Good intro, dude. Damn, the production slaps. Dude, this is so well produced. It could be any music behind this kind of production, and I feel like it would just slice through like a knife. I mean, damn, this sounds good. A tale of paranoia, frustration, and sleeplessness. I was looking through my window. I was looking through my eyes. There was a big black car coming. Get off a street outside. Come in. Go into a pipe dream. No one listens anyway. Yeah, it does sound like a paranoid man. Honestly, I'm getting so locked in and lost in the noise of this whole thing. I feel like following along with the lyrics is kind of difficult. And again, that's not a... Oops, sorry about that. That's not a problem at all. I love that. I love that I'm getting so lost in the sound. It feels like there, you know, will be more to unfold with a return listen. Oh my god, the rotating... Dude, the groove is nice, it's complex. Drums are amazing. I've never heard of these guys. The shit sounds amazing. Like, it just sounds amazing. Thank you, Dynamic. Apparently this is their only album. What happened to them? What's up, JW? I've watched you for years, but I still stand by your current reaction and whatever people say is your favorite videos of all time. Wow, Mike, I'm glad you enjoy them. Honestly, these songs are just sucking me in. The sound is amazing. I Can't Sleep is clearly, I mean, with the extra context, it's helping. But yeah, I Can't Sleep. Paranoia. I Can't Sleep. There's some shit going on. This is the only album they made. They ended up breaking up shortly because they hated it. Really? They didn't feel like it reflected the sound of the band. That's unfortunate. Because this shit sounds great so far. I like it. Next song, Timeless Melody. Everything's just so tightly produced, dude. How immediately, once the sound loses me a tiny bit, I realized that that was the entire foundation of my enjoyment. And I think that's kind of the problem with a casual listen like this. If you are missing out on all the details, it feels like a completely different experience when all of a sudden something isn't completely grabbing you in. As I'm not super crazy on the singing here, and I'm realizing that I might have to dive a little bit deeper. The melody always finds me whenever the thought reminds me, breaking the chain inside my head. The melody chord unwinds me. A timeless melody, it could be about something that permanently gets stuck in your head. Thank you. Yeah, I'm not super in love with the lyrics of this one. I will say that the song concepts have been really interesting, but I just feel like they're not as striking as many other bands that have done these sort of like simple tracks. There's just something about this that feels like there's like a little bit of something missing. I don't know what it is, but it does feel like once you kind of get off that euphoric cloud of sound, it feels like the experience was leaving not much of an impact. I love this album, and they have a ton of songs released that aren't from the studio album, but I haven't liked any of it besides BBC sessions, live recordings that they did. Yeah, no, the music's fantastic. It's like it sounds so good that I'm willing to actually just like look past some of the things that I feel like I'm not super in love with. Really, Mike? Thank you. Like the blend here of sounds. I'm not super crazy on the vocals on this one. Yeah, I feel a little bit frustrated with the vocal performance on this one, as it actually kind of comes off a little bit annoying. I bite you on the lyrics, it makes me feel transcendent. And seemingly being about music is just pulled off beautifully. Well, you're wrong. Okay, the song's a shrug. I have some issues with the track that I feel like, especially in comparison with what actually, like, and that's the problem though, is because it kind of set me off on this specific path of something I'm looking for specifically from this album, which is just euphoric carrying sounds. Well, I know that you say that that is the song that probably does that exact same thing for you. This is one of those that I feel like, well, it has its moments where it really strikes. It also has its moments where it feels derivative, copy and paste, and like it ran out of ideas. So, kind of underwhelmed with this track a little bit. I relate to you with a lot after a few years, so I'm invested in how you've changed as a person. I mean, you know, there was that one incident where, you know, I called a bunch of kids that a forbidden word, you know, and then got canceled and then lost my platform. And then, of course, I blamed everybody else and, you know, I had to live on the streets. And then I documented my life on the streets and, you know, so that was a messy Brad Taste in Music arc right there. Next song, Liberty Ship. Pretty catchy. I am the toilet of the old ship. I'm not super in love with this track. This one feels like it's losing me a little bit. Yeah, this feels super boring and derivative. Like this feels unadventurous even for the 90s. I already feel like this album's kind of fallen off a little bit for me. As the first two songs, like, man. It It sounds euphoric, truly, and this Liberty Ship song is just not, I'm not having it. The song is just not hitting me.
Why don't I look at the lyrics on Spotify?
I don't know.
I just don't.
Kind of a snoozer.
I'm curious about revisiting this one.
The song isn't on YouTube. Can I request on Spotify? Just send it any YouTube link and then tell me what the song is to look it up on Spotify. However much you send in for the YouTube link, and if you just say, hey, this is just a filler link for you to listen on Spotify, then I'll just look it up there. Yeah, Liberty Ship is a low shrug for me. I just thought that was really mediocre. Like, I didn't think that any moments of that really stuck out. I'm not crazy about the writing here on the hook. That one really felt like a drag, and I would skip it every single time. That did literally nothing for me, especially considering the next song is the big mother freaking smash hit single. Okay, it's There She Goes. I'm curious if I've ever heard this song before. Let's give it a shot. Here's Link from Hamster Tube. Damn, even the mixing here is better, you know what I mean? Solid vibe, not bad. Yeah, I feel like the complex things that really hooked me into this album are back on this track. Like, this just feels like a really blissful listen. Reminds me of the time my father went to the grocery store, you know? To buy milk for that last time. And then my mother followed. I definitely understand why this is the big hit. It really feels like it was crafted with that sort of idea in mind. But I mean, it's very effective, so I don't have a problem with it. Especially considering the biggest appeal for this so far was just this feeling of euphoria and not as much like lyrics going into crazy depth of anything. I think that this is more appealing to me than the last two.
Yeah,
Spy on the Ball, one of my favorites. Yeah, popular for a good reason. I like it a lot. Yep, sounds really sweet. Feeling any better than you were a few minutes back? Yes, I am.
I feel like taking a little bit of a break helped me quite a bit.
Mm, there she goes. Yeah, so it's a catchy-ass song. It's a great vibe. Really sweet, really cute. Got my attention. Good one. All right. All right, the big song is good. It's not just overrated. Next song, Doldrum. Let's see what Doldrum is. Doldrum, yeah. You are city street scum, yeah. Bum 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 bum. The droney singing sounds on this. If you know what's good for you, then you know what you can do. Please get on the bus and down. Get on the bus, get high. All my life goes by in Doldrum. Yeah, admittingly, I feel like there are moments here that are better produced than others. Like, Doldrum, I feel like, has its moments, but also it just doesn't really stand out in the same way as the Big Smash single here. It does similar things, but just not to the same degree, which it does make it kind of hard to compare things when, or hard not to compare things when you are going for a very similar sound across the board. Is that scene where Shrek fights the knights? The fuck? You must be mistaken. I wasn't even following along with the lyrics on that one. Good vibe. Not really going for much else, but I don't really feel like it has to, as once again, I mean, to complain about this track lyrically would be like going against literally everything that's been happening throughout this project. It feels like the casual listening experience for this album is the most enjoyable, and that's why I'm kind of sticking with it. It's going for pretty much an aesthetic, and I think it kind of nails it. Give it a light smiley ball. Not one of my favorite moments, honestly one of the more forgettable tracks here, but still keeps the vibe alive. Next song, Feeling. I got a feeling.
Thank you.
out for that feeling. It's a feeling, I can feel it to the ceiling.
Band from the 60s, or are they trying to sound like they're from the 60s? I think it's the prior. They sound like they're trying to sound like the 60s. Today it's been a fantastic stream. Even the songs that are underwhelming have still managed to entertain me. I'm having a very good time. Once again, I actually appreciate the simplicity of this because it makes my job easy. I could say that the vibe was solid, even though that's it. Vibe was solid. Smiley ball. Well, what can I say? It's not something that I'm rushing out the door to listen to again, as it's not the most rewarding experience, but I'm still having a good time, and I think that's worth something. Next song, Way Out. Yeah, this is a good time. I just feel like this is not the most fulfilling album, and because of that, it feels like there is something missing with this, and I can understand why they were probably a little bit underwhelmed with this thing, as it isn't really much of an artistic statement as much as it is just kind of pumping out really solid, cute little rock tunes. You have to wonder how much a record label pressure factored into the 60s throwback sound here. Even though it is kind of a 60s throwback sound, I feel like for me personally, since, look, I don't know shit about the 60s, all right? That's barely a generation I've explored. I just don't really have the same sort of issue as some other people might. The lyrics here talking about get me out of this, especially since this song is kind of a solid wall and a vibe. It feels like it could also be a bit self-conscious on the song itself. It wants to get out, but also it feels like at the end here it kind of wants to break out of the track. Like what I'm hearing. Way Out is a smiley ball for me. Again, good vibe. It's not something I'm super blown away by, but it's doing some cool things in it, and I enjoy the production a lot. I do feel like I'm kind of running out of things to say with this. You may have not closed the queue based on what people are saying here. I think I did. Yeah, the queue's closed. Next song, I Owe You. I Owe You what exactly? We're going to find out. I feel like this song has been done already on this album. Like, I know I'm kind of just vibing out, but this song feels a bit redundant.
We're a happy family.
Yeah, this one does sound uninspired. This shit. I love you, you love me. Yeah, a lot of tracks start to kind of blend together. It seems like one of those albums that if you like the sound of like the first half, then you're not really going to have a whole lot of problems with the rest of this. Which, I mean, it's fair. It just, once again, feels like it hits a ceiling. This song's super corny. I think that the existence of Barney has destroyed any sort of unironic enjoyment of this track for me. There's no harm in kissing your neighbor's arm. Trucker rock? I wouldn't go that far. Shrek avoids child support type beat. IOU is pretty bad. I give it a red headphones. I think it's got some issues that like, it's just the negatives for me completely outweigh anything on this song. It feels extremely corny. Yeah, this one I feel like is kind of a failure of a track. And it really shows a level of, a lack of inspiration here. Like, I was able to vibe along with some things because it felt like the there were no, like, major issues with the tracks, but I feel like that one all of a sudden just kind of breaks everything that I liked about this project while, like, introducing nothing that I'm really enjoying. Next song, Freedom Song. Hey, you know what? That's a chance to bounce back. We still got 3 tracks.
What the fuck is this?
Dynamic. There's no such thing as falling off, alright? As far as I'm concerned, music is music. I appreciate you sharing anything with me. Seriously. Like, I'm very appreciative of, like, everything. The place for everyone. Live and die, our kingdom come. But until the web is spun, everybody must have fun. I'm not scared to die, God help me. We went to the same schools and we... Having said, this song's kind of terrible, not gonna lie. This one's a bit of a... Like, 50 seconds in, I'm already done with this one. Learn the same rules of lament. The knot will never come undone. Accidents shall mess none. There isn't any shit broke. Theater core, the Doors.
Donkey spended all the money on the blackjack table, now they're broke. What the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, man, even the guitar here sounds super low energy.
How much does it cost to do an album reaction? A lot.
There's a place for everyone. Live and die, our kingdom come. But until the web is spun, everybody must have fun. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, I feel like Freedom Song is just an extremely mediocre track. I do appreciate that it's a little bit different, and that's honestly what's saving it for me. I'd give it a shrug because of that, because it's switching it up and doing something a little more like interesting than the last one, which just felt like it was kind of copying itself in a really weak manner. I do think that there are some interesting lyrics here, but man, this one felt like a bit of a drag. Yeah, it was a different one, exactly. And it felt like it kind of satisfied a sort of itch in a way. So I didn't fully hate that track, but just not really giving me the same sort of satisfaction the rest of this project did. Next song, Failure. I like this one, the fact that this one sounds a little bit different too. Once again, I feel like the vibe's a bit restored for me. I like this trip. I wonder what this band's gonna do for 8 minutes straight. Good question. I have no idea either.